Oh, my children have lost their minds today. And also their shoes, which doesn't matter because they can't go outside until they finish their homework, which they will literally never do. Hi, I'm Mrs. Soap and Clay. Let's make stuff. Welcome back to the channel. You are here for another round of 365 days of soap, and today we are doing a lather retest. So about 6 weeks ago, we made and tested 5-play soaps, and a few weeks after that, we did the big lather test with another 5 bars. And both of these, you know, groups of soaps have had at least 4 weeks to cure up, and I thought we should do another retest of the lather to see what they look like once they've lost all their water weight and what their lather becomes, you know, in their finished product. Are you ready to go check it out? Let's go. So we are back again for the big lather retest and the clay soaps retest. So on the left there, we have the 5 clay soaps that we made. And on the right, we have the soaps that were made for the big lather test. Now we've got the red clay there, the bentonite, the activated charcoal, the kaolin, and the dead sea clay. Now this lather should, clay soaps are very cool. So in, you know, their initial lather stage, and they harden very quickly because of the clay. So you have a good indication of what the lather is going to be. But you see here with the dead sea clay that we started first, yeah, that lather is pretty stable. It's very similar to what you experienced with the very first test when the soap was just a few days old. Now, this one is the kaolin. And I love kaolin clay in soap because sort of the longer that the bark cures, the more bubbly and effervescent the lather becomes. And it's just delightful. It's one of my most favorite things to use in soap because it has just, I mean, look at that, the difference between the two. Really, really tight bubbles in the first test and big, beautiful, just bubbly bubbles in the second. And that's every kaolin clay soap I've ever experienced. The lather just gets better and better with time. Now, the activated charcoal soap, this is one that usually stays pretty consistent from first blush, first test to a fully cured bar. And that's gonna be, you know, true of this guy as well. The cool thing about activated charcoal, you can't really tell, I don't suppose, but there's a grit to it. There's a firmness to the bar, right? It makes it sort of harder to slip through your hands, if that makes sense. You have something to grab onto, there's more friction. I love that about activated charcoal bars. You could definitely feel the difference. It's not as slippery. Now, this is the bentonite bar. And bentonite, usually the lather really gets sort of bigger and is has a more sustaining effect over time. And that's great. It's a good thing to incorporate into things like shave soaps because you get a little bit of the friction that you would expect from the activated charcoal bar, but you also get a really big lather that really holds up really well in itself and it's nice to shave with. You can see, yeah, it went from creamy to very, very bubbly. It's a lovely lather. And the last to retest in the clay line is going to be the red clay. Now, red clay is very cool. Again, this is, actually it's not even a proper red clay. It's like a pink Brazilian because I was out of stock on the red clay. And so it is basically kaolin clay, and you're going to, yeah, you see the exact same thing that you'd expect with kaolin. Really big, nice, you know, big, beautiful lather in the fully cured bar. But also interestingly in this one, it also has some good sustainability to it, right? You have that soap or that lather that really holds up on itself and creates, yeah, it's beautiful. That's an awesome lather. Whereas in the first batch, it was, you know, creamier, and the bubbles were a little bit, you know, less. Now, this is the bar of soap that we made for the clay test that has no clay in it. So just to give you a reference for essentially both groups, this is what it looks like, what, you know, just a regular artisan bar of soap looks like, and there's the lather. And now we are moving on to the big lather retest. And the first in the big lather retest will be the aloe vera soap. Now, in the original aloe vera soap, it was actually kind of, I don't know, it's an okay lather, I suppose. But with this one, it's interesting. I cannot work up a really good lather. Like, the lather is actually less now than it was in the first test, which is very interesting. And now we have the honey soap. Now, the honey soap had, you know, a decent lather when we first started with it. It took a little bit to work it up. But now look at this. That is not the case at all. This lather is working up so beautifully right away. There's no real work involved. Whereas, you know, the first test, it was a very slight lather. There wasn't a lot going on there. And that's, it's just beautiful. That's what happens, you know, after a bar has finished curing and really comes into its own. Now, this one is the almond milk. And I mean, you see right away, look how quickly that lather started with the almond milk soap. Whereas you see in the other picture, when we tested it cured or fresh, it took some work. But look at that. Those are big, beautiful bubbles. So that's almond milk plus kaolin clay. And that's a winner. That's a slam dunk right there. This one is the coconut milk soap that we tested. And also, look at that. It's a nice lather right off the bat. The milk soaps are definitely the big winners in the retest of the big lather test. And I like that a lot. It's very nice. And now we're going to move on to the dumpster fire bar, the beer soap. No. And this one should, with, you know, as I would expect with a beer soap, it lathers really well. Big, beautiful bubble right away. But that was also the case, you know, when we tested it when it was still sort of fresh. It's really easy to lather, and it has a good lather right off the bat, and that has settled into its own and really created an extraordinary lather. And there's the retest, day 54. Let me know which one you like better.
And there it is, the clay and big lather retest. Now, I love the clay soaps, and you can see that the lather remained basically stable from the initial batches to, you know, the finished products. And the big lather retest, that was actually interesting. The aloe soaps, they actually have sort of less of a lather now than they did when they were freshly minted. And the honey soap, as well as the almond soap, they're both beautiful. That lather just blew me away. So those are big winners in my book. And of course, the beer is still going to be my big winner overall, because adding alcohols to soap is just, it's excellent for your lather properties, as well as, you know, all the amino acids and all the cool things that, you know, you get when you add, you know, beer to your soaps. But yeah, as far as lather goes, that's kind of what it looks like, you know, 4 weeks later. So I thought you guys might want an update on the lather and what that does once the bar is fully cured. I'm so glad you guys were around for another day, 365 days of soap. Thank you so much. If you have any questions about the process or the soaps that we make, or if you have been incorporating any sort of sugars or alcohols or clays into your recipes and need some fine tuning, feel free to let me know. You can drop a note in the comments. You can message me. I'm available everywhere. If you are interested in a big soapy giveaway, yeah, we're still doing that. So once we hit 500 subs, we're going to be giving out a giant box of soapy love, which is awesome. If you're interested in following me on social media, you can do that too. I am on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. And if you are interested in, you know, continuing to stick around for the soapy journey, that would be awesome. You can subscribe to the channel. That would be sweet. I would love that forever. And yeah, that is it for me today. I will see you guys tomorrow.